Democrat and former Clinton aide throws temper tantrum after he's confronted by Fox News host. Sometimes even the news can be very entertaining. If you didn't catch the episode the other day on Fox News with Melissa Francis, you missed it. If you wanted to see a Democrat squirm from just being asked basic questions, well, this was a pretty interesting entertainment to say the least. Let's just say, Simon Rosenberg is a nothing more than a DC swamp creature. Media bias is rampant in today's world. While most media outlets run liberal, Fox News is the more right-leaning network. And viewers got some serious red meat recently, when a Democrat and former Clinton aide threw an epic temper tantrum live on air. Simon Rosenberg formerly served as an aide on Democrat Bill Clinton's campaign, and appeared Wednesday on Fox News Happening Now with Melissa Francis. "What is one thing that you think you can change about this tax bill that would make it more palatable to Democrats?" Francis asked, which immediately set Rosenberg on edge. "I don't think that's the issue, Melissa," he said, to which Francis responded, "We're not going to do talking points." Rosenberg wanted to talk about tax cuts to the rich. Francis, trying to get a straight answer out of him, asked, "Is that the estate tax?" Rosenberg blew up, shouting, "May I finish?" After Rosenberg continued to not answer the question, Francis then turned her attention to David Avella, asking him what he would do to that would bring Democrats to the table, joking, "Not Simon, who's not willing to come to the table at all, but real Democrats to the table." Avella answered the question, and then Francis again asked Rosenberg to answer the question. "I'm not answering the question," Simon screamed at her. "I know you are not answering the question, that's the problem," Francis said. The two continued to bicker and fight, but at the end of the interview, Francis tried to take the high road. She joked that she and Rosenberg can't always fight like this, and said that the two of them should grab a drink sometime. "Melissa, don't worry," Rosenberg responded. "Because I'm never coming back on this show ever again, so it doesn't really matter, thank you." He removed his earpiece and lapel mic while still on camera. Social media loved the argument. At Melissa Francis Fox News, "Very smart and couldn't be nicer," was just old by a Democrat pundit, after being cornered with facts on taxes, he would never come on the show again. Ripped off his earpiece, walked out. Simon Rosenberg is the president of the Democratic group NDN. He founded the centrist New Democrat Network in 1996. It has since rebranded itself as the NDN. Rosenberg previously worked on former President Bill Clinton's 1992 campaign, and for the Democratic National Committee in the early years of Clinton's presidency. Sad news is, Simon Rosenberg seems to have a pattern of stomping his feet and acting like a spoiled child throwing a tantrum. That's right. It seems back a few years ago he did the same thing. In 2011, he told conservative Ben Ferguson to shut up before throwing down his mic and walking off the set of a debate. Like I said, Rosenberg has a history of being acting like a spoiled child. Guess he must have been around Hillary too long. According to NDN's website, Rosenberg's bio states, "An experienced television news producer and highly regarded political strategist and thinker, Simon has spent three decades in national media and politics. He is a veteran of two presidential campaigns, including a leading role in the famous 1992 Clinton War Room. In his current capacity as president of NDN, New Policy Institute, Simon advises leading politicians, administration officials and policymakers on a wide range of issues here in the United States and abroad. He is a frequent commentator in the national media, appearing regularly in major newspapers and websites, political journals and on cable and network television. A few years ago, GQ magazine named him of the 50 most powerful people in Washington, and he currently writes a weekly column on American politics for U.S. News and World Report." In other words, Simon Rosenberg is deep in heart of the DC swamp. "I'm sorry, but this is unfortunately just one of many reasons why President Trump needs to hash drain the swamp."